Hey everyone, in this Fusion tutorial, we will go over the basics of masking. The stuff that will make it way easier for you to build more advanced and complex motion graphics later on. So if you really want to level up your motion graphics, understanding how masking works is absolutely essential. Alright, so let's dive in. Right-click on your footage and select Open in Fusion. Before we start creating anything fancy, let's understand what masking actually is in Fusion. Okay, let's grab a background node from the toolbar and connect it to the main pipeline using a merge node. Just drag and merge, hover it over the line until it changes color, and drop it. Now link the output of the background node to the green input of the merge. Then select the background node and pick any color you like. As you can see, it fills the entire screen with that color. Now let's say we want to create a shape, for example, a lower third bar. Let's bring in a rectangle node. You will see its green outline appear in the viewer. That's your shape. You can drag and resize it however you like. But right now, notice something. The rectangle itself has no color. If you check the inspector, you will see there is no color control here. So, if you want an orange rectangle, here is what we do. Hover over the blue input of the background node. It says Effect Mask. That's where the masking happens. When we connect the rectangle node to this blue input, we are basically telling the background node, hey, only show your orange color inside this rectangle shape and leave the rest of the screen. And boom, now we have got an orange rectangle on screen. If you resize or move the rectangle, the orange area changes with it. So here is the key idea. In Fusion, we combine two nodes to create shapes. The background node provides the color. And the shape node, like our rectangle, defines where that color shows up. Now that you have got a solid grasp of how masking works, I will show you how to make your text grab colors directly from your footage. Let's clean up our workspace a bit, delete all the previous nodes, including the old media in. Now let me grab a colorful time-lapse clip from the media pool. That will be our new media in node. Connect it straight to the media out so you can see it in the viewer. Next, right-click the media in node, copy and paste it to create a duplicate. And connect this copy to the main pipeline. Now grab a text node. Type in your text and pick a nice bold font. Here is the trick. Connect your text node to the blue mask input of the merge node. At first, you will not see your text. Select your main media in node, hit Shift plus space, and add a Gaussian blur node. In the inspector, set the blur strength to around 0.8 or 0.9. And our text shows up. Now select your text node again and bump up the size a little. Hit play. And wow, our text is now grabbing live colors straight from the footage. So let's take things up a notch and create an advanced logo reveal animation using the same masking technique you just learned. First, let's tidy up. Delete all the nodes except the media in and media out nodes. Next, grab a text node and type in your logo. Or if you already have a logo PNG, bring it in instead. Connect the output of your text to the output of the media in node. Choose your font. Pick a nice color. And adjust the size. Then under the layout tab, move the center X value to the left so about half of your logo disappears off screen. Make sure you are at frame 0. And add a keyframe on the center X. Now move about 10 frames forward and bring the center X value back to center your logo again. Hit play. Nice, we have got a simple slide in animation. But let's make it more dynamic using masking. Grab a rectangle node and connect it to the blue mask input of the merge node. Adjust the size so it covers your logo completely. Go back to frame 0. Position the rectangle so it hides the logo entirely. And in the inspector, check the invert box. Now hit play. Boom. Our logo appears out of thin air, letter by letter. And that's it. If you learned something new, hit like and subscribe.